Now, for those of you who don't know, Capcom Fighting All-Stars was a 3D fighting game that was initially planned for arcades and the PlayStation 2. It was along the lines of King of Fighters Maximum Impact or even the Street Fighter EX series, as it was taking a 2D fighter and bringing it into 3D, but still retaining that 2D feel. The only seemingly 3D aspect to the game was the ability to sidestep, though. The game's roster would consist of characters from other Capcom games, as well as some original ones. The cast would consist of Ryu, Chun-Li, Alex, Charlie, Mike Haggard, Poison, Batsu, Akira, Strider, and four new characters, Dee, Rook, Ingrid, and Death. Now, based on the little footage there is, the game does look interesting, so why was it cancelled, you may be asking yourself. Well, from what I understand, the game had a limited beta test in 2003, during which it received very negative feedback from players, and after a few more months of development, the game was cancelled. Exactly why it was cancelled is a tad vague. I can only speculate that maybe Capcom thought that after the negative feedback, the game couldn't necessarily be salvaged, or maybe it wasn't worth salvaging, but like I said, it's pretty vague.
Now, as for the big deep story that he won, the game would focus on Metro City as a mysterious villain named Death had planted bombs around the city. Mayor Hagar called upon a group of new heroes called the Code Holders to come together to help save the city, and along the way they would be joined by several other characters from the Capcom universe who found themselves in Metro City at this time. Now, these bombs actually played into the overall story in kind of a big way, as there would be multiple endings to the game that would depend on how fast you beat it. Essentially, the bombs were on a timer, meaning the quicker you beat the game, the better the ending you got. The game introduced three brand new characters to be the central heroes of the story: Ingrid, Dee, and Rook, although in later interviews they clarified his name was actually Luke. These three heroes, as well as the villain Death, were known as Code Holders, as they had special cells in their body that gave them powers. Now, Capcom would show this game off at the Tokyo Game Show in 2003, while also doing location tests in arcades around Japan at the same time. But sadly, later that year the game was cancelled, and while Tanabe says there were several reasons for this, he doesn't really go into any details why.
So they felt it was warranted that the Code Holders should go on location to gather fan feedback. By this point, almost a year and a half, the game had mostly been finished, although it still needed fine-tuning, extra characters, and a translation pass. Unfortunately, the location testing did not go so well, as many players came away unimpressed by All-Stars from both a visual and gameplay standpoint. The game didn't look very advanced when compared to the newest Tekken or Virtua Fighter, and the gameplay was singled out as feeling a bit awkward and not in line with what most people expected or wanted. These tests went so poorly, even in Japan, that the fate of the entire game was hanging in the balance back at Capcom headquarters. Tanabe's team wanted to take that feedback to improve the game, and even started to staff up to expedite that process, but before that could truly kick off, the axe came down. Tanabe and some of the staff moved on to Flagship Limited, an independent studio co-funded by Capcom, Sega, and Nintendo, who would support them on various titles. This left the work on Fighting All-Stars just sitting there, unused, which was eerily similar to its precursor, CVS3. This was the state of fighting games at Capcom around this time, abandoned and neglected. Capcom higher-ups, however, were displeased that money had been spent without seeing a return.
Well, maybe you should have canceled the goddamn thing!
Thus, they scrambled to do something with the concept. Hidetoshi Ishizawa, who had been working on Capcom Fighter since Alpha 2, was assigned to pick up the pieces, but one of the main producers backing him up had dropped out, and thus Yoshinori Ono stepped in to manage the game's production. The order from Capcom bigwigs was thus: finish this shit as fast as possible and as cheaply as possible. Thus, Capcom Fighting Jam / Evolution was born!
Capcom has some of the most beloved franchises in the history of video games. I'd be willing to say they're second only to Nintendo in terms of memorable characters and worlds. And fans of the Versus games have been saying for years, you know what? Marvel keeps giving you all these legal problems when you try and cross over with them. Why not just do a Capcom versus Capcom game? Why not just make a fighting game featuring characters from your own series crossing over? This is why. Yeah, here's the thing about Capcom. They are stuck in their ways so firmly, it borders on being superstitious. They are famous for saying that if a game comes out and underperforms, they will gladly let that game, those characters, that entire franchise die. But let me be clear. Ono ain't to blame for Fighting Evolution because nobody could have salvaged this. Because Capcom didn't just pick a young developer with no experience leading a project like this, they also gave him a massively reduced budget and only 1 year to complete the game. Now, you might think, okay, that sounds bad. But not too bad. I mean, he already had a nearly complete game sitting right there in Fighting All-Stars. Even if the budget is small, he had a whole year to address the problems that the testers had with this game, right? Yeah, that would have been the smart thing to do. Funny thing about that, though, Ono couldn't use anything from Fighting All-Stars because he had to start completely from scratch. Why is that? Why, if you have a nearly complete game that you had poured time and money into, would you not just fix the problems in that game rather than starting on a brand new game? That's like saying, hey, there's a hole in our roof. Should we patch it up? Nah, let's just build a brand new house from the ground up. Honestly, there is no way for us to know exactly what went down behind the scenes here. Capcom is a very secretive company after all.
Damn. Look. Oh, God. Oh, f*** you. F*** you. What? I don't f***ing believe it. I do not f***ing believe it. I actually do not believe it. That they're using one of the original characters from Capcom Fighting All-Stars, the canceled fighting game. The similarities are definitely f***ing striking. God damn it, it might be him. Anyone just watched Matt McMuscle's video on Capcom Fighting Jam got a healthy spoonful of the history of this game and this game being canceled, which led to the existence of Capcom Fighting Jam, right? Different tattoos. Right, I mean, I get it. He does have different tattoos, but that could be a redesign thing, you know? And that's actually kind of similar. Like, this is technically like a wing design, and this is like some early 2000s wing design. Dog tags, he's wearing like a dream catcher around his f***ing neck. What the hell is this design? Look at the birthday. Oh, f***. You, what? When did they say his release date was? November 12th? They just said November? did it happen by the most technical f***ing way possible? The fish is at the end of the line and it's pulling the boat. Oh, I don't know if I like what I got into at this point. Oh. There's a star in his intro? Are you telling me Capcom All-Star? It keeps going. Oh, God. I hate you right now. I hate you so much. You're pissing me off at this point. Oh, you have to be f***ing shitting me. You have to be. Oh, okay. He is confirming it. Thank you to Luke. It's a completely different person from the Luke in this world. By the way, where'd you get the screenshot? Did you take a picture of this? Can you let us play that game? This is an interesting observation. Somehow this guy found possibly a functioning build of Capcom Fighting All-Star, the canceled fighting game. I think Evil was the final boss of this game. By the way, this game was done. I think it was close to being 99% finished and they needed to do some polish on it and that was it. But this game was nearly finished. And this was one of Capcom's first 3D fighting games that they would make in-house, and it wasn't made by Eureka. So it's a very weird game, right? It's a very weird game with a very weird history. And apparently it wasn't very good, but it to me, it's one of the most fascinating things Capcom's ever done. I would love if this leaked onto the internet in some way at some point. My God, dude, I would love to actually play this game. It's confirmed. He just took those photos of the game, so it's running at Capcom. Oh my God. So there's where the last time Akira showed up in a fighting game was this one. Unfortunately, never released. Let's see.
What was this? This game never happened. Wait, they have this much footage of this game? They have this much. This game looks solid. Damn. Yo, I feel like we need to do like a petition. Like just tell Capcom just to release it and be like, yo, like we'll promise we won't like crap on the game or anything like that. We just want you to release the game so we can just play it.